On the floor tonight, Greg, how does that shape what we're about to see, do you think?
Well, Kevin, guys are going to play smart, and they're going to be in position to make plays. So this could come down to just who makes more of the big shots.
And now the Golden State Warriors starters. Sharing the wing spots, it's Thompson and Wiggins. Otto Porter Jr. out there with Looney, and it's Curry in at the point guard position. So it's the Clippers now after the miss from Klay Thompson. Pass to Powell. Zubats with the screen for Powell. Just four to shoot. Thompson with the rebound. All right, let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Hey, Kevin, I was able to talk with Tyronn Lue for just a minute. Unsurprisingly, he's focused on what it might take to slow down Steph Curry. Coach told me whenever possible, we'd like to force him to shoot over length. But that's going to take a total team effort and quick rotations. It's easier said than done. Kevin?
Thanks, David. Just three to shoot. It's Porter outside. That doesn't go, and he's 0-1 from the field. Outside Batum. Outside Jackson. Zubats against Curry. It's good.
And you want more of this from Jackson. The more unselfish he is, the better the team.
Here's Curry. His last outing with 20 points. Pass to Looney. Batum against Wiggins. Thompson outside. Here's the three. Buries the long-range jumper.
And that's exactly what he's looking for, draining the triple.
And here in the first, closing in on 2 minutes play.
And Wiggins thrived as a secondary option. Seems that is the role he's best fit for. His efficiency soared.
Now here's Porter. Norman Powell unable to get his last shot to go. Back to Thompson. Let's the three fly. Good, and Curry gets the assist. Thompson's got six.
Yeah, raise your hand if you're surprised that Klay Thompson racked up three more points.
And with Wiggins, he didn't face the same pressure, Greg. It was a huge weight off his shoulders.
And that mental aspect impacts players. Wiggins was asked to do less, and as a result, ended up doing more.
Shot clock at six. Knocks down the three ball.
And I like the back and forth here, showing confidence from range.
It seems like they're going to find out who can make the deepest threes. Right now, it's a shootout.
Now here's Curry. Misses in close.
That's a surprise. I mean, really out of character for him to miss when the defense is not right up on it.
And Thompson sends it back.
Klay showing some signs that time of that primetime defense he can bring.
The shot is good, and so is his shooting tonight. 3 for 4. Now about 3 minutes gone in the first quarter. Powell against Thompson. Now Powell. His numbers are looking pretty good. He's got his scoring average up around 18.5 points a game. Jackson finds Batum. Over Wiggins. A shot by Batum. No good. Curry passes to Porter. Curry looking around. Thompson outside. For the three. The shot. No good. So Los Angeles will take it the other way. Their last game, a win against the Lakers. Looking to carry it into this one.
Tremendous poise on the offensive end. Overall, they did not settle for bad shots.
Saw the box score the next day and thought about those percentages. They had guys just going off in that one.
Count that one.
Wiggins making quick decisions with the ball, not wasting any time getting that shot off.
And here is Los Angeles now, trailing by five. Powell in the high post, working on Thompson. Powell kicks to Jackson. Outside Batum, outside Jackson.
Over Curry.
Bank shot, no good.
Well, that's a shot they want just about on every possession if they can get it. He doesn't make them all, but still very much a high percentage look.
Here's Looney. He had 10 points in the win against Sacramento.
And don't forget about the work he did on the boards. His rebounding was a huge help in that game.
And Wiggins' game continues to evolve. You saw that right there. Good eye movement, found the shooter.
Clippers trail by 8. And the Clippers decide to take their first timeout here. For those teams that did make a deal at the trade deadline, Greg, how hard is it to integrate a new player midseason?
It can be tough. Guys who need the ball to be effective can be a little harder maybe to integrate, but for certain role players, it's just how quickly they learn the system.
Big group substitution here for the Clippers. Serge Ibaka has checked in for Zubats. Robert Covington comes in for Marcus Morris. Mann's checked in for Nicholas Batum. And it's Luke Kennard in for Norman Powell. Jackson against Payton. Outside Jackson. Covington a screen on Payton. Jackson. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Bielitsa. And here's a look at some numbers for Stephen Curry. Ibaka with a screen on Payton. Jackson kicks to Ibaka. Pass to Kennard. 6 on the shot clock. And it's Bielitsa with the foul. That's his first foul. Covington a screen on Payton. Here's Jackson. Outside Covington. The pass to Mann. Shot clock at 5. The Clippers need to get off a shot.
Now the offense is sputtering a bit here, starting to fall behind.
And again, it's the Clippers missing. And Poole gets it to go.
Oh, great ball movement there.
Jackson with it. He had 25 points in the win against the Lakers. Driving to the basket. Their offense, stone cold. Another miss there.
And already, they've staked out a noticeable advantage in terms of aggression and controlling the backboard.
Bielitsa sets the pick for Payton. And a missed layup.
As a big, once you get position inside, it allows you to fight and come away with a lot of tough boards.
I got yours.
Outside Jackson.
Yo, set it up.
Passes it to Ibaka. Over Payton. And misses it off the right side of the rim.
Probably not the shot that was drawn up for that possession, but you can't pass it up and you can't knock it down.
And the rejection by Ibaka. Here's Mann, guarded by Poole. Covington setting the pick for Kennard. Here he goes. Lays it up off the glass.
And the team likes to use Kennard as a floor-spacing kind of player, but he decides to do damage that time inside.
Warriors leading by 8.
Been interesting to watch the evolution of Serge Ibaka, just improving that shooting and that confidence to be a perimeter threat.
Now, here's Bielitsa. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. Here's Mann. He's covered by Iguodala. Back to Ibaka. shoots over Poole. Shot's good by Ibaka.
Ibaka mixing it up again there on the inside using his size.
Payton passes to Poole. And Bialica kicks to Poole. Kennard with the rebound. Clippers trail by six. The dish to Jackson. Covington passes to Mann. Screened by Ibaka. Pass to Kennard. Fires for three. A shot that time, not on target. Poole on the wing. Shoots over Covington, and the shot falls short this time. And so the first quarter is in the books. Warriors lead by six. We'll be back shortly live from Staples Center in downtown Los Angeles. And this Warriors team has an interesting mix of championship vets with hungry young players. Andrew Wiggins spoke about that great dynamic.
The rest of our team love to teach. The good players are always telling us why we did it, why you should do this, why you should do that. So it's been a lot of learning and also been very exciting for the young players.
Agreed. No doubt Wiggins has been soaking up that wisdom. Greg stepping up his game in the process.
Yeah, a big culture shift coming from Minnesota, and he's blossomed under the tutelage of these Hall of Famers.
And thanks again for tuning in. If you're just joining us, we've played through one quarter of action so far. And a look at how the offensive approach has been going here so far for the Warriors.
They've definitely had a hot hand from three-point range. Always nice to get off to a good start.
And you also have to give them some credit for the ball movement today. Their assist numbers a little bit above average. That's impressive.
We've got Marcus Morris. Also Robert Covington out there. Batum is out there with Powell. And it's Coffey in at the two-guard position. That's who's out there for the Clippers. Now let's go to the sideline and catch up with our Hall of Famer, David Aldridge.
Thank you, Kevin. Paul George has taken some heat in recent years. He says people get so caught up in what other folks think. I'm Paul George. I don't care to be anybody else. I am who I am. You love it or you don't. Simple as that. Guys, with his play on the floor, he has answered all of his critics.
He is certainly playing at an elite level. EA, thank you. To the paint. Powell dishes to Covington. Pass to Coffey. Driving in, and Looney sends it back.
Looney's starting to play a little bit angry right now, and that's helping this defense be more aggressive.
I'm glad we got to see the mobile one block once more. What a play.
And that is a huge block. Given how close this game is, a stop like that was right on point.
Zubats is checked in for the Clippers. We're about a minute and a half into the second quarter now. The shot by Powell, no good.
And when you can't get anything to fall, it definitely gets in your head.
Especially if you're a player that doesn't get a lot of shot attempts, but otherwise, the mindset is, I just got to get the next one to go. And you don't want to put that much pressure on yourself.
Bottom line, you need shooters on your team who can space the floor.
Oh, there's no doubt he's a legitimate threat from downtown, and he's demonstrating that in this game.
Now here's Powell. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. Yep, it counts.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Warriors leading by five. Right side Curry launches a three, and it's the Clippers with the rebound. And here in the second quarter of action, with a hair under 2.5 minutes played so far. And we see teams around the league trying to integrate star veterans with talented rookies. Greg, it's not always easy, is it?
Not at all, Kevin. And a lot of times it becomes a choice between win now or win later. Though the teams with great coaching and development can oftentimes do both.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
All First one falls for him.
And a guy who's bounced around the league a little. Surprising, given that Morris is a solid shooter and a pretty good defender and rebounder.
And he makes both free throws. And a little under 2.5 minutes gone by here in the second quarter. Powell against Curry. Outside, Porter. Takes it inside. Good, and Curry gets the assist. Curry's got his fourth assist in this one.
Playing with high activity there. Porter makes a real impact when he feels included in the offense.
Clippers trail by 5. Quarter number 2, around 3 minutes gone by. Here's Powell. Basket made, just his second this contest. He's 2 for 7 now.
Yeah, here's a list of things I don't want to do, and right at the top is guard that guy.
Curry passes to Thompson. Here's Looney. Rebound by the Clippers. Zubats has got his 5th rebound right now in the game. Kicks it to Powell. Here in the second quarter, just under 3.5 minutes played. Good D by Thompson.
It wouldn't surprise me to see him find his touch and still be a factor. Don't count them out yet.
And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line.
That's the aggressive part of Andrew Wiggins coming out of him, forcing the defender that time to get his hand in there.
First trip to the free throw line for him in this one.
Numbers this year at the line below 70, so when he's getting to the line, not nearly as effective as you'd like.
Free throw good, Wiggins.
Andrew Wiggins, one of those guys who just doesn't miss a lot of games and is always able to bounce back from any off night offensively.
And that one goes in. 2 from the line that time. And almost 4 minutes gone here in the second quarter of play. Here's Coffey. He's covered by Thompson. Coffey passes to Powell. Over Curry. Will not go. This is off the front iron. And so it's Wiggins with it. He'll bring it up for the Golden State Warriors. They've led by as much as 10.
Toughness there from Andrew Wiggins. Would like to see more baskets like that one from him.
So it's the Clippers now. 7-point differential. Powell against Curry. Now the pass to Batum. Out to the right wing. Passes it to Coffey. Clock at 6. He kicks to Powell. Shoots the 3. And the Clippers miss again.
His touch has left him in this quarter. Nowhere close to the kind of output they need from him.
Pass to Looney. Curry on the wing. Guarded by Powell. Finally gets one to fall. He's now 1 for 5 with his first make.
Steph, such an ideal pick and roll guy. The threat of the long ball always there. So whether he's shooting or passing, the defense has a hard time keeping up. Well, gravity is very, very real. And Steph Curry has the most of any NBA player right now.
and the Warriors with a completely new five on the floor.
And checking out some numbers for Reggie Jackson. How last month turned out for him, he's putting up about 16 points a game, 4 assists, and 3 rebounds. And you look at the numbers he's been putting up, fantastic scoring production from him.
Yeah, hard to ask for anything more at this point. He's really stepped up, and he's really delivered.
Kennard, the pass to Jackson. Ibaka with a screen on Payton. 6 to shoot. Second chance shot, and the layup is up and in. He has 6.
It took a little bit of time, but now he's taking the pen off the cap and putting his mark on this game.
Poole kicks to Bjelica. Pass to Payton. Back to Bjelica. A one near Iguodala as he lets it go. Hits it from 3-point range.
And the arc Iguodala has on his 3-point shots, almost like he's drawing rain from time to time.
Into the lane, to the left side wing. Some nice passing here by Los Angeles. Ibaka with a screen on Bjelica. The three. No good that time. And it's the Warriors taking it the other way. Here's Iguodala. Plays it up and banks it in. Iguodala's got the lead up to 12 now for the Warriors.
Oh, we've seen this so much throughout Andre Iguodala's career. Just a gamer who refuses to let the defense get to him.
Now here's Jackson. He's still scoreless so far in this one. With the drive. Rebound by Bjelica. Warriors leading by 12. Iguodala outside and out of bounds as the Clippers gain possession. When these players get to the free throw line, it's nearly automatic. The 2K leaderboard show us this month's free throw shooting percentage leader. Now you look at Poole, the best in the NBA. You put him on the line and it's nearly automatic.
And during that time, guys, he's been an absolute dead-eye shooter from the free throw line. His concentration just never wavers.
Now here's Jackson. Following the miss by Marcus Morris. Takes the 13-footer. The Warriors pull it in.
Not sure what the D was doing there. Clearly a breakdown. You can ill afford to give a guy like him that good a look.
And there's the pass to Bjelica. And it's off from 3-point range. For the Warriors, they won their last contest, that game against the Kings.
Yeah, in that game, the offense was firing on all cylinders, partly because the other team's defense was a no-show.
Yeah, with the defense struggling like that, I think they just stayed with a healthy, consistent pace to get that win.
And is out of bounds to the Clippers as the Clippers retain possession. And the Clippers making a switch here. Covington's checked in. Here's Jackson. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. That one's in there. The Warrior lead is cut down to 9 in the bucket from Covington.
Beautiful stroke off the catch and shoot from Robert Covington that time.
6-second difference between shot and game clock. Cool. Almost, but it rolls out.
Not a bad shot from the mid-range. The D's giving it to him, and he's usually got an eye in that kind of range.
Payton against Jackson. Ibaka sets the pick for Jackson. That's good on the jump shot. Jackson's got his first 2 points.
Yeah, that's a high percentage look when the D doesn't fight over the screen.
Yeah, the coach over there just asking for one simple thing, and that's some effort. Got burned on that one.
And so we wrap up the first half. The Warriors on top, leading by 7. We'll be back shortly live from Staples Center in downtown Los Angeles.
Welcome to halftime, everybody. Before we go any further, a look ahead to the games yet to be played tonight. Out in Sacramento, it'll be the Kings against the Thunder. Start time 10 Eastern, 7 Pacific.
That's one like EJ and Shaq playing 2K against each other. Weak.
Come on, Jet.
And now, looking at Klay Thompson's contributions in the first half, unbelievable.
When he's hot, it's like a fire that spreads quick. Oh, he's so hot, it's a fire right here on the desk. He's determined. He's relentless. Hey, give me a fire extinguisher. And before you know it, you're torched.
Thank you for being with us. Now let's send it to Kevin Harlan for the second half tip.
And for those of you just tuning in, thanks for being with us. The second half of this game still to play. Klay Thompson has been sensational.
Yeah, it's been a great performance from him, really staying focused on quality shots.
Yeah, this is showing that they're not going to play at anybody else's pace but their own.
And if you're just joining us in this one, first half is in the books, one half to go. So for the Golden State Warriors right now, at the guard spots, it's Curry and Thompson. Looney out there with Porter. And it's Wiggins in at the three. Down low. Here's Powell. And it's Looney with the rebound. Looney's got 6 rebounds now in the game.
Hate to say it, but if they're still trailing at the final buzzer, a lot of this is going to be felt by him. His shooting tonight has just been atrocious.
The assist totals, Kevin, just continue to grow. They're way ahead in that category. Ball movement has been flawless.
It's stolen by Curry, and it's the Warriors on the break. And he could not get that one to go. Out of contact, and he'll go to the line for two.
Klay takes that foul and still getting his shot off.
Well, something, Greg, we can't take for granted. It's nice just to see Klay Thompson out on the floor.
No doubt, Kevin. And, you know, the NBA is just a better league.
Oh, take a break.
With a healthy Klay Thompson. This team more fun to watch. Good for humor and one incredible performance a year.
That free throw good from Thompson. And, Brent, you look at the career of Klay Thompson. He's had improvements every step of the way.
Yeah, and he's still just an elite shooter that, because of what Steph does, because of Draymond's unselfishness, you know, Klay is going to add 25 points in the blink of an eye. That, along with his defense, just make that backcourt something special.
And so Thompson nails both of them.
And Klay Thompson has collected a fair share of some pretty impressive records and accomplishments, along with the team commitment to championship caliber play.
Now here's Powell. Drives to the hoop. That one, no good. And it's Curry with the ball, bringing it up for the Warriors. That matchup falls in the middle game of this 3-game trip. Shot, high post, Green for 2 points. Curry's got the lead up to 14 now for the Warriors.
That's a testament to Curry's awareness of everything that's going on around him. No one better at finding some space for a shot.
And we've got an update here, so let's check in with David Aldridge reporting from the sideline.
Thank you, Kevin. Well, mid-range jumpers are something of a lost art these days. They're still practiced by superstars like Kawhi Leonard. Coach Ty Lue said, why not work on the shots that teams are giving up? Down the stretch, mid-range shots win games, playoffs too. If you shoot it at a high clip, it's just as good as a three for me. Guys?
And they do shoot it at a good clip, and they rely on it quite a bit. David, thank you.
This is where Morris can kill you. He's pretty much playing that in-between game.
And here's Porter. He's averaging just around 8.5 points a game. The three ball. It's Curry. That time on the assist by Porter. Curry's got a pair of threes now here in the third for the Warriors. Second half of play with just under 2.5 minutes gone. Jackson kicks to Zubats. And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Zubats. And a moment here to check out who the Golden State Warriors have coming up. On Monday, they're off to Oklahoma City to face off with the Thunder. Then on Wednesday, they'll be matching up against Mike Conley and the Utah Jazz.
You know, some might look ahead at the schedule and start marking off how many wins they'll wind up with, but I think that's a trap. You can't take any nights off in the NBA, and you've got to stay in the moment.
Up top, Powell. He's covered by Thompson. Powell kicks to Jackson. Clippers moving the ball around. Back to Powell. Five to shoot. Zubac's a screen on Thompson. The shot by Powell, no good.
Time for some consideration in the passing category, maybe, Kevin. The shot is just not on. Get somebody else going.
Curry passes to Looney. Porter looking it over. Golden State needs to get off a shot. Curry can't get it to go. Clippers trail by 15. And Batum kicks to Jackson. Passes it to Zubac. And again, the turnover by the Clippers.
And now a quick review at the numbers for Norman Powell. He's around 18 points per game, 3 rebounds, and 2 assists. And you look at the numbers he's been putting up. Fantastic scoring production from him.
Yeah, hard to ask for anything more at this point. He's really stepped up, and he's really delivered.
Now here's Curry. They lead by the biggest margin of the game, 15 points. Here's Looney, and the rejection by Zubac. Now here's Powell. Pass to Batum. Zubac with the screen for Batum. An easy 2 points on the layup. Batum's got 5 points so far.
Well, that's how you draw it up right there. A screen to shed the defense, a quick move to the bucket, and you get the lay-in. D has been just completely helpless and turned around. He's so dangerous when he's in this kind of rhythm.
Clippers trail by 15. Los Angeles calls timeout.
And something we've seen the last few years, boxing ones thrown at Curry, although they've had mixed success.
And the Clippers with a whole new lineup now. Then for the Warriors, Bielitsa. He checks in for Kevon Looney. Iguodala comes in for Porter. And Poole subbed in for Thompson. Ibaka dishes to Covington. Covington a screen on Curry. Here's Kennard, and he drops it in from the low post. Kennard's got his second basket of the game. And amazing to even consider using a box and one in the NBA, isn't it, Greg? But Curry does that with his offense to the teams that defend him.
Kevin, I agree, and it did work well in the 2019 finals. Curry has started to adjust to that look. Much harder to use when Curry has other options on offense.
Nailed from three-point land.
Having a lot of trouble stopping the three-point shot.
Mann passes to Ibaka. Here's Coffey. Outside, Covington. And the Clippers getting another bucket right there. Warriors leading by 14. Here's Poole. One of the dependable scorers on the team. He's averaging close to 17 points a game. Here's Curry with the three. And another three for Golden State.
Yeah, great outside shooting. Really fueling this run.
Here's Coffey, guarded by Poole. Covington wide open. He fires from outside off the mark. Warriors have gone 6 of 10 from the field in the third quarter. It's blocked. And there's a minute 45 left here in the third quarter. Here's Mann. He's covered by Iguodala. Shot clock at 6. Here's Mann. Chalk up 2 there. Mann's got his first basket.
And that tells the tale here today, guys. Throughout this game, they've been able to get the ball in tight and finish.
Iguodala, the pass to Wiggins. The lead pass was put in just the right spot. And the Warriors lead by 17. 109 left in the third. Pass to Ibaka. Here's Coffey, covered by Wiggins. 4-3, Covington. Rebound by Bialica. Warriors leading by 17. There's the pass to Curry. From deep. That one doesn't go. L.A. has gone 0-2 from deep to start things here in the second half. Covington, a screen on Wiggins. Mann. The Warriors pull it in. Bialica's got his 4th rebound with that last one here tonight. Now, here's Poole. Defense right on him. Can't connect from 13 feet out.
The defense did a really good job of choking off the middle there once he got inside.
Coffey passes to Kennard. Here is Ibaka, covered by Wiggins. Shots good by Ibaka.
Now there's some easy offense there. Keep finding looks in that area, and their shooting percentages tonight are going to be off the charts.
And so it's the Golden State Warriors. Their lead at 15 going into the break. Their defense has been active and effective. We've got more NBA basketball coming your way in just a minute. And let's take now this moment to bring up our State Farm assist of the game.
It's just true artistry right there. I mean, great decision on where to go with the ball, and how about the perfect delivery?
Yeah, those are the kind of plays that you want to put on a canvas. Just beautiful basketball.
And we reach the fourth quarter in a game that may be already out of hand. Jackson is the point with Kennard on the wing. Robert Covington out there with Batum, and it's Zubats in at the center filling out the middle. That's who's out there for the Clippers. That is out of bounds. The Warriors able to retain possession here. Norman Powell's checked in for Luke Kennard. Here's Curry, driving the lane, and that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Zubats. An outstanding defensive play to earn the Mobile One block.
And that has got to help the morale of this team. Let's see if that sets up a run here.
And the Warriors with possession here. Just 2 to shoot. Thompson for the triple. And they get it back. Passes to Payton. They set the pick. There's another block.
A defensive stalwart so far. That's 6 blocks.
Greg protecting the rim. Love the hustle. Zubats with it. Now Payton defending. It's going to be out of bounds. Los Angeles will retain possession. Oh, 60 seconds off the clock here in the fourth. And the ball travels out of bounds. It was last touched by Peyton. Zubats finds Jackson. Down to five on the shot clock. It's a nice passing here by Los Angeles. That's a two from Powell.
And really, after that strong first half, he has been in quite the tailspin.
Peyton against Powell. And the rejection by Zubats. Batum scanning the floor. Powell against Porter. Outside for Jackson. Going inside. Here's Zubats. It's good. The assist this time from Jackson.
Now, this is what his coaches like to see. Jackson making an effort to distribute the ball in that situation.
Warriors leading by 13. We're about 2 minutes into the fourth quarter in this one. Thompson outside. There's the three. Scores the bucket. He's 7 for 11 and continues to look good.
Well, if he's hitting shots from there, he becomes so much more dangerous.
And here is Los Angeles now. They played a great fourth quarter defensively, allowing only 3 points. Looking to get it going. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
Clearly a foul.
And a moment to look at the scoring approach in terms of where the points are coming from for the Warriors.
Fantastic passing. We saw it in the first half, and it's carried over here in the second.
You might give them a standing O for what they've done behind the arc tonight as well. That has certainly been a go-to shot for them, and tonight it's working.
Marcus Morris has checked in for the Clippers. And the second free throw, good. And so Curry will bring it up for Golden State. The lead is 15. Stolen by Jackson. Peyton against Powell. Now Zubats. Pass to Jackson. Outside Batum. Inside Powell. Got a piece of it. Thompson against Batum. It's Thompson off the drive.
Nice dedicated drive there from Clay. He committed to it, got all the way in there for contact.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
That free throw, no good.
Wow, what, did he have something in his eye on that shot?
Maybe. And he's good on the second. Clippers trail by 16. Powell down low, covered by Peyton. He gets that one. Here's Curry. Pass to Peyton. Here's Looney. Dishes it to Curry. Beyond the arc. Drains the three-pointer. Curry's got 14 points here in the second half.
They've given up a lot of three-pointers here today.
Curry against Jackson. We've played just over 3.5 minutes now in the fourth quarter. Driving the lane, and he finishes nicely on the layup.
That was a tough shot. I mean, Jackson has practiced that, but he makes it look effortless right there.
Warriors leading by 15. Curry passes to Looney. Payton against Powell. Payton kicks to Thompson. That's in, coming off an assist from Payton. Thompson's got 25 points in the game.
I mean, he is bringing his game, guys. Another jumper from distance.
For Los Angeles, they've gone 3 of 5 here in the fourth quarter. Pretty good numbers coming out of the break. And now let's take a look at the New Balance player of the game, Klay Thompson.
And it's been a ridiculous performance in the best sense possible. I mean, everything about his game has been working. And no matter what they've thrown at him, he's had the answer.
On the road, in a tough atmosphere, he's taken on the role of star tonight. If one of their other players came up short, he picked up the slack to make sure they'll be walking out of here with a win. Curry against Jackson, and he lobs it up toward the rim. And it's the Warriors on the break. Wiggins with the ball. The pass to Curry. Here's Looney. Porter with it. To the inside. Here's Thompson. Misses the layup. Jackson looking around. Tries the spin move. Up top, Powell. He's covered by Thompson. And there's the whistle on the shot. Took the foul. Shot misses. He'll be shooting two. And the first one drops. Good on both. And so Curry will bring it up for the Warriors. To the paint, Batum with the steal. And pushing it up, here's Los Angeles, and Jackson gets it to go.
And running with a full head of steam, but completely under control.
Yeah, you think he's comfortable at that speed? He's done it so many times before, just an absolute blur in transition, and that helps get the rhythm going.
And here is Curry. Here's Thompson. They get it again. Yep, that one goes. Looney's got his first points of the game.
Looney in the right spot there. Good presence on the inside as he boxes the defense out and sends the ball right up.
Pass to Jackson. Wiggins against Batum. Pass to Powell. Shot clock at 5. Back to Batum. From past the arc, Porter pulls it in. Porter's got 4 rebounds now tonight. Pass to Looney. On the wing, Wiggins. Defended by Batum. Here's Curry with the 3. And another 3 for Golden State.
They're in total command of this game with time starting to run out.
Yeah, looking for a miracle worker out there is the opposing coaching staff. I don't know that they have one. This game seems to be well in hand.
Thompson against Powell. Looney passes to Curry. Some nice passing by Golden State here. Looney down low, working on Zubats. Out of bounds, the Clippers take possession.
And guys, what we saw here tonight is one side having everything going for them. Huge margin of victory for the Warriors.
Look at their number of assists.
You know, they didn't get stuck in those one-on-one situations, and they got the ball to the guys with the best matchups. Easy drives, open jumpers, and great ball movement.
And this will make it 41 victories for them on the year.
The one player that really stands out, of course, in this one, it was a dazzling game for Klay Thompson.
Every time he shot it, it seemed like it was going to drop in. And if it didn't, everyone was surprised.
Warriors leading by 19. There's 57 seconds left in the fourth. Looney down low. Zubac defending. Looney with the bucket.
And once they smelled blood in the water, you could see the killer instinct take over.
Yeah, up until that point, a competitive game. But once they broke through that barrier, it was all them. Complete control.
Kennard kicks to Ibaka. The pass to Kennard. Here's Mann. In the corner, Ibaka with it. And the ball out of play. The Warriors will inbound. Here's Curry. 2 seconds separate in the shot clock and game clock. Passes it to Looney. Back to Curry. They set the pick. Fires from deep. Rebounded by Serge Ibaka. Now, here's Kennard. So we see the Warriors taking the game here. To come into an opponent's building and dominate the way they did tonight says, I think, Greg, an awful lot about this team.
I guess they don't need home cooking to feel at home. I mean, Kevin, just a masterful performance all the way around.
Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. For Brent Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. See you later.